All sounds from one preset. This is the FM3 and FC6 foot controller that you are looking at on your screen right at this moment. And this is a nice 2017 Mexican, actually, San Dimas hardtail by Charvel, with a 59 in the neck position and a JB in the back position. Seymour Duncan pickups, of course, which I can split with this little coil split here. And the three-way position switch gives me a lot of versatility. I chose this because of that versatility. I've got a gig coming up on Monday, which is a big thing for me because we haven't been able to play since March sometime. It's with a fellow called James Rain, who, if you're living in America or Japan or Europe, where I know most of my viewership is, hello everybody out there. You may not have heard of James, but he's quite humongous over here in Australia, and I'll leave a link so you can watch too if you like. It's coming up this Monday evening in Australia, which is probably going to be Tuesday for you. Anyway, you can check out the link. But the point of this video is that I've had to write myself a preset, a basic preset. I could use a lot of presets, but I like to use one with a whole lot of different scenes that gets me through the gig with a whole lot of different timbres or timbres. What's the correct word? Tones. And a versatile guitar that will do it too. I originally was thinking of this guy, this PRS, and I may still use it, but at the moment, this little Charvel is doing the job. So I would like to firstly give you this preset so you can play with it yourself and, you know, make it yours. And secondly, I'd like to demonstrate it for you, which is why you're still watching me now. Hopefully you'll watch me to the end. It's going to be a long video because there are 8 scenes to get through and a bit of explaining about what each is doing. The first scene is called Super Clean, and it's super clean because it features this particular amp model, which is the Custom Audio 3, and no cabinet, and that's what gives it the cleanliness. Which is particularly good with this 59 neck pickup. If you split it, it gets a little bit too tingy. But just like that, it's just right. If we go back to the JB, it's probably too midi. But just there, that's the ticket. So as you can see, I've got the bright switch on. The treble's rolled down a little bit. The input drive is down. It's being tamed by a multi-comp later on in the signal path over here. The chorus that I'm using is the warm stereo chorus, but I've adulterated it because I have turned up the high cut, which was previously at about 2K or something like that, and I've turned the drive down. So it's still warm, but it's more high fidelity. So chorus off. And chorus on. Pretty gorgeous sound. I think I'll be quite happy using that. Scene 2 is the Carol Ann trip, Carol Ann Overdrive 2 with the good old 103 basket weave TV mix. So this is a pretty classic rock sound. Let's get that switch fixed. The Overdrive 2, as has been summarized by Alan Phillips, the guy who designed the Carol Ann Overdrive 2, and Yek and a few other people, is kind of a bit dumble and a lot plexi. So it's got that fast attack of a plexi without the serious hair and that lovely mid-range that you might find in one of Howard Dumble's amps. So I use it as a bass, and if I want to go crazy with it, I can bring in the drive at any given time, which is the 808, with the drive down and the level up, and just do this. So it's a good all-round classic rock amp, and you can hear it's being flanked by the digital stereo delay, whose low cut and high cut I have dealt with accordingly. There's a fair bit of level wound in there, but you know, you can decide whether or not to turn it on or off. I haven't got any reverbs because they tend to chew up the CPU, and I'm already pushing it at 76, 77 now. So the delays, and there are a couple of them, will do. Let's go back to the amp block, and we'll move on to scene number three, which is the good old deluxe reverb. Now, the deluxe is it's a tricky thing because, you know, it sounds good on its own, just like that. I've just split the coils in, but you don't realise its charms completely until you're using it on stage because that mid-range just cuts right through. So if I stuck, say, an overdrive in front of it, like, what have we got here? What have I decided on? Oh, the old super overdrive. So it's a versatile little beast. The cab that I'm using, or the IR rather, is a York Audio Deluxe Reverb cab, and I know that Justin shot these with the Oxford speaker, which is what you would have found in the original 1965 Blackface. There are great factory IRs as well, but for the $20 that Justin charges, and you get about 100 IRs for each different format, Kemper, Axe FX, Line 6, etc., these are well worth it. But you will find something close in the factory IRs, although not the Oxford, as far as I can tell. So I just thought I'd point that out. Once you load this preset up, it will have whatever I can find that sounds close, but visit York Audio site because it's well worth the $20 spent to get the authentic sound. Scene 4 is clean cab. Now, I know these are scattered, but they make sense when I'm looking at my FC6 down here. Clean cab is basically an adulteration of the super clean preset. And the difference is that it has got a cabinet, and the cabinet is a USA traditional 57, which is the Messer cabinet, and a compressor in front of it. So if I turn on the super, super clean preset, as opposed to the clean cabinet preset, you can hear that the second one, which is the clean cabinet preset, has got a bit more of a fatter overdrive and it's more compressed. So sometimes I have to do stuff like, that's what that'll be used for, whereas the super clean preset will be used for stuff like that beautiful stuff. Hello, Jeff Scott, the famous guitar player who played on a lot of that early stuff. Oh, I miss you, mate. Hope you're well. All right, scene number 5, 1959, super lead plexi. Every preset should have one, just because it does that. All right, there's our amp settings. I've got the treble up a little bit. Treble and mid at about 7 o'clock, and everything else is pretty much the same. The cabinet again is the good old Legacy 103 basket weave TV mix. If I was to bring a drive in, it would be, of course, the 808, which is going to sound like this. What quite fun. Not sure how often I'm going to get to use it like that, but it's there. And the other great thing about the 1959 is that when you wind back here, which I tend to do because I'm an old school player, gorgeous clean sound. Rock and roll. All right. How are we going for time? Doesn't matter. Let's just roll on. Scene six is what I call seagulls, because at the very start of our set, I have to do an intro that sounds like this. That sort of stuff. I've got a Seagulls 2 as well, which is based around the Deluxe Reverb amp. So I can do that as well, and the final scene is a Deluxe Reverb with the old Super Overdrive in front of it, just so I can hit it and be quickly into... that sort of territory, but if I hit the drive block, I can get out of that territory pretty quick. Straight back into my Deluxe sound. Now, there are a few added extras here. You will notice there's a rotary block, and if I hit the rotary block... and you'll see that the rate is moving between fast and slow, and that is because it is attached to an LFO that I have programmed. So basically that frees up your foot. You have to use a brake control because it's going to do it for you. That's the height of laziness, I know, but it works for me, so I'm not too fussed. If we go turn rotary block off for a moment, and if we go over to Mr. Phaser here, he's basically set on the old Eddie Van Halen script. Which, if I'm using the 1959 SLP... to put me into that brown sound kind of territory, which I love. The wah is on auto engage, and you'll see that it's on auto engage on foot control pedal number one, so you will have to disable that if you don't use a foot control pedal, because you'll see that it will be on all the time. So please go in and disengage that, but otherwise it sounds like this. Let's turn the phaser off for a moment. And it sounds pretty darn good when you're in that super clean sound. Reminds me of those Johnny Marr tones that he used to get with Dada and Electronic after he left the Smiths. Anyway, there you go. So Gig Rig JB-59, and that's named after the pickups, of course, which you'll find in a lot of kind of current or 80s upwards guitars. It'll probably suit pretty well with most of those models. So you've got the Super Clean, you've got the OD2, you've got one step up in the 59 SLP. You got a halfway with the clean. And you've got a deluxe. All in one preset with a ton of effects. CPU's not maxed out yet. Check the levels for your own guitar, you know, and some of the tones and that sort of thing, because everybody will have different tastes and tweaks. And just have fun with it. And maybe I'll see you looking through your screen on next week's gig. Bye.